often get the question that, you know, why are we doing this? Why are we playing in this space? And I don't know what your take is on it, but I find, you know, a good way to think about it is you've got, you know, over 50 years of legacy of really being the best at measurement, measuring the real physical phenomenon, whether it be, you know, acoustic or vibration that we work with a lot, temperature, pressure, electric current, et cetera. And it's, you know, that what happens there is the measurement is happening at the sensing modality, and it's using ADI's conversion technologies, best in class. And as a result, we're producing the best measurements. And if you think about it, that's really the source of the data, and that rich source of data, we felt we could take the next step and deliver some meaning, provide some meaning, some real insights for people, for humans. And, you know, that gets us to that topic of human in the loop as well. And, you know, really what we're trying to do is start some kind of dialogue, but machines inherently can't talk to humans. So, you know, it seems like there's a need for an interpreter or an interpretation box, if you like, in between. And that's where ADI AutoSense comes in. So it's really starting a dialogue, not between the human and the machine, but it's starting a dialogue between the human and the AI interpretation engine, in this case, ADI AutoSense. And importantly, when we talk about the humans, we're not talking about data scientists, we're talking about, you know, those experts, those domain experts in their field that you referenced, people that understand their processes, people that really understand their machines and their assets, and then enhancing their experience with the machines and creating that dialogue.
When you recognize the dog barking, someone at some point told you what a dog was and helped you identify dogs, and then you created that connection between the dog and the bark. Machine learning is about using some known data described by someone to infer the description of new data. But if you stop there, well, you have a nice system, and with a typical AutoSense installation, you would then have a good anomaly detection model in place. But the idea is, well, don't stop there. Now, the system is designed so that you can interact with it way more. So in this case, you had this loose belt, and the guy say, oh yeah, on this machine, we just checked it. We had this loose belt going. And so it's just saying it to AutoSense, and AutoSense now is connecting this loose belt sensing data to the actual meaning of it, the loose belt. And then these guys know how to connect that to the actual action to be performed, tightening it or replacing it, for example. And this is going back and forth and back and forth. And by enabling this dialogue, you have a system that is in the hand of customers without data scientists in the middle, will evolve every day thanks to the interaction with all these domain experts over time. So you have this constant progression through interaction, and that's what intelligence is, and this is what AI is doing for us.